A space race fit for the 21st century is being funded by a Russian billionaire who told Express Co. UK humanity stands on the verge of living in space. But will the human race move on to colonize the solar system? The ambitious space dream of leaving the planet is the brainchild of Russian Azeri billionaire and scientist Igor Ashibili. As the leader of the world's first space nation Asgardia, the Dr. Ashibili is confident the science is there to back his claims. But the self-professed Asgardian leader does not think it is just his ambitions he has set out to fulfill. Instead, the Russian billionaire argued it has been the collective goal of humanity to fly to the stars from the day we first learned how to walk. Towards this goal, the micronation marked its inception in 2016 with a list of goals scientists and engineers will need to accomplish first. The primary directive for the next 22 years is the conception and birth of the first human being in space. As outlandish as the concept might seem on the surface, Dr. Ashibili is certain the goal can and will be achieved. He said, "The challenges have already been identified and they are described in our stratagem. They will comprise of space radiation protection, in particular, for long-term travel in space, and artificial gravity. Without accomplishing both, the birth of a human child in space will be impossible. That is a key mission," Dr. Ashibili added. "The medical solutions to those challenges are already available and some experiments have already been performed. Given how rapidly technical development accelerated over the last 100 years, I think we are on track." Asgardia discussed various aspects of living in space at its first Space Science and Investment Congress in Darmstadt, Germany, between the 14th of October and the 16th of October. The conference discussed the dangers of prolonged exposure to space radiation and the science behind safe human conception in space. Another key topic of the discussions was the viability of introducing artificial gravity to space habitats. The Congress was also attended by city investors and space industry players who discussed the commercial aspect of funding ambitious space-based projects. Asgardia considers itself to be a full-fledged nation with a territorial stake in space. The stake comes off the back of a satellite launch in 2017 when Asgardia flew a small satellite dubbed Asgardia 1 into Earth orbit. Since then, the micronation has opened its doors to members and citizens wanting to support the initiative. Members of Asgardia have the opportunity to seek out citizenship with passports and ID cards to boot, but citizenship does come at a cost. The space nation charges an annual citizenship fee of £86.37, €100. To date, Asgardia boasts on its website more than 18,900 residents and another 1.059 million Asgardians. All of this, Dr. Ashibili said, will help Asgardia accomplish its goals in the foreseeable future. However, what does the Russian billionaire think about the prospect of humans moving to every corner of the solar system? Dr. Ashibili said, "I'm not really seeing any prospects in the solar system, in terms of human habitats or development. As far as the solar system is concerned, the Earth and the Moon are quite enough. So, I would think any human expansion should go beyond the solar system. Those should be missions 50 years long and longer."